इकरा बिस्मे रब्बिकल लज़ी खलक, रीड इन द नेम ऑफ योर लॉर्ड हू क्रिएटेड। एजुकेशन स्टार्ट्स एट होम। देयर इज एन ओल्ड अफ्रीकन सेइंग दैट इट टेक्स अ होल विलेज टू रेज अ चाइल्ड। टू सीक नॉलेज इन इस्लाम इज अ सेक्रेट ड्यूटी, इट इज ऑब्लिगेटरी ऑन एवरी मुस्लिम मैन और वुमन। कुरान मेंशंस दैट अल्लाह बेयर्स विटनेस, देन द एंजल्स बेयर विटनेस, एंड देन हू बेयर्स विटनेस? The person with knowledge, the person with understanding, then he bears witness. Islam teaches us to have a complete ilm of the word and of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ultimate truth, the perfect truth. There is only one truth in this world. Everything else is opinions, people's own comments. But the truth is one. And the idea for every Muslim is to find out that truth and then spread it. A person shouldn't have to make a choice whether he wants to be a man of science or a man of religion. He should be a man of both. Merge the two ilms together and get the maximum benefit out of it. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. I'd like to welcome you all by saying assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, almighty God, be on you all. The topic for today is a very important one, and especially in today's time. The topic is education in Islam. اقرا بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الانسان من علق इकरा व रब्बुकल अकरम अल्लज़ी अल्लमा बिल कलम अल्लमल इंसाना मा लम यअलम। रीड इन द नेम ऑफ योर लॉर्ड हू क्रिएटेड, क्रिएटेड मैन फ्रॉम अ क्लॉट ऑफ ब्लड, अ क्लिंगिंग लीच लाइक सब्सटेंस। रीड एंड योर लॉर्ड इज मोस्ट जेनरस, ही हू टॉट बाय द पेन टॉट मैन दैट व्हिच ही न्यू नॉट। These were the verses from Surah Al-Alaq, chapter 96, verses 1 to 5. They were the first verses that were ever revealed to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Iqra, read, learn, study, recite in the name of your Lord. If I was to end today's session right now, that would be more than enough. Because this one verse summarizes entirely the concept of education in Islam. Now, when we speak about defining education or what we actually consider education to be, most of us think that education is the knowledge we gain from schools, colleges and universities. Whereas in fact, education starts at home. Every child is born in fitrah, in deen ul-fitr, in the pure form, in the nature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is born as a Muslim. Later the environment and the atmosphere around him begin to take an effect on his personality. His parents, his family, his friends, his entire surroundings mold his character. There is an old African saying that it takes a whole village to raise a child. And that is very true. The main responsibility, first of all, lies with the parents. As the child spends most of his time at home, the responsibility of the parents is to educate him from the moment he begins to understand and realize the world around him. He needs to be taught about his deen, the concept of La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, that there is no God except Allah and that Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the messenger of Allah. He needs to be taught right from wrong, good versus bad. He needs to be taught prayer, about fasting, about zakat or charity or hajj, pilgrimage. If we just leave all forms of education aside, this knowledge, this education alone will ensure that whenever he dies, and he will die one day, kullu nafsun zaiqatul maut, every soul shall have a taste of death, so that whenever he dies, the hereafter is secured for him. This is the best gift that any parent can give to their child. Now, the idea is that we must seek ilm or knowledge and have good tarbiyah, or what we call in Urdu tarbiyat, upbringing, manners, how to conduct oneself, knowing right from wrong, following a certain value system. Now, we all live in a culture, and if it is not our own culture, by default, it is somebody else's culture that we're following. What is the Muslim culture? What does Islam teach us? What are our values? What is the belief system that we have to follow as Muslims? Catholic schools are not trying to raise Muslims. Jewish schools are not trying to raise Muslims. Our public school system is again something that has been left over by the British, and we're still following the British curriculum. So how can we expect our children to be good Muslims when the surroundings that we as parents are offering to them are going in the exact opposite direction to what Islam teaches us? As I said earlier, it takes a whole village to raise a child, not just the parents. The analogy which I'd like to use here is that if you take your child, tie him up and throw him in the river and expect him to swim out of it and reach the shore safely, that is the analogy of what is happening right now in our world. Most of the students come out of these educational institutes thinking what? Thinking that Islam is outdated. Islam was 1400 years ago. I have another dream to follow. Big beachfront property, fast cars, women, luxuries, hefty bank accounts, money, money, money. The ultimate goal at the end of a university is what? I need to get certain worldly things so that I can be considered successful, so that people look up to me and people say, wow, what a person. He's got the car, he's got a house, he's got a fancy this and that, everything, and I get respect. That is the ultimate goal. Let's chase that dream, seeking an education to make the life of this world as luxurious as humanly possible. Not caring about the millions of people around us who are dying or sick or starving, but focus on me. What do I want? What do I need? It mentions in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 14. Beautified for people is the love of that which they desire, of women and sons, heaped up sums of gold and silver, fine branded horses, and wealth from cattle and well-tilled land. That is the enjoyment of this worldly life. But Allah has with him the best return. Let me repeat that so that it resounds a little. But Allah has with him the best return. And Allah has with him the best return. No matter what you crave or desire in this life, something far greater, far superior waits for you in the hereafter. It would be an absolute miracle that a child who goes through this kind of education system, our conventional education system, manages to still be a good Muslim at the end of the day. It is indeed a fantastic miracle. It mentions in Surah Al-Imran, chapter 3, verse 54, that they plan and Allah plans, and Allah is the best of planners. So despite being put against all odds, a student who goes into such a system which is not depicting Islamic values in any way, at the end of the day, if he still comes out a good Muslim, indeed, a plan of Allah has been involved somewhere or the other. What happened to tarbiyah at school or at home? Have we fulfilled our responsibility? Just because a Maulvi Sahab comes to my house and teaches me Arabic Quran, which I don't understand, does not fulfill the responsibility and the requirement that I have to learn about my religion. Now let's talk about the importance of education itself. Why is education so important? Why must we educate ourselves? It mentions in Surah Al-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 78. Allah brought you out of the wombs of your mothers, having no knowledge at all, knowing absolutely nothing. But then He gave you the faculties of hearing and sight and intellect so that you may give thanks and be appreciative of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah ta'ala mentions, when you were born and you came out of the womb of your mother, you had no knowledge. Your mind was absolutely blank. Then Allah gave you the five senses. He gave you hearing and sight. And on top of that, He gave you intellect to think, to process all of that information. Why? so that you become defiant of Allah, so that with the intellect that Allah gave you, you try to disprove Him and disagree with Him and follow your own path? No. So that you may give thanks to Allah and be appreciative. To seek knowledge in Islam is a sacred duty. It is obligatory on every Muslim, man or woman. There is no discrimination. It is farz on Muslim men and Muslim women to seek an education. As I mentioned earlier, the first word revealed in the Quran was Iqra, read, seek knowledge, educate yourselves. Now why does Islam make it farz for all Muslims to seek an education? By the way, it is the only religion that does so, that makes it an absolute compulsion on all men and women to seek an education.